Hey everybody, this is Mr. Ainsworth, and we are going into yet another lesson on parabolas, and we're going to study the effects of what are called h and k. We're going to take a look at our first family of functions here, y equals x minus h quantity squared, and see what the effects of h are, and how does it affect the parent function y equals x squared. And then we're going to look at our second parent, or our second value, which is k, and see what happens when you add or subtract something to x squared. How does that affect the parabola? You do that by investing. So if you want to interact with me, get your calculator. We're going to do it by hand, but also use the TI-84 and probably another program as well. But we're going to get involved here with the study of parabolas with two specific functions. Right here, y equals quantity of x minus h squared. And the second one right here, y equals x squared plus k. And specifically, what happens when you change the values of h and k? To do that, you simply study the effects and plot the function and look at it. Okay, so let's go ahead and let's start off with our parent function, y equals x squared. We say and call it a parent function because all the other ones are kind of look like this one here, y equals x squared, but they're going to be shifted on the plane. And you're going to see that. And the question is, what kind of shift are we talking about? Is it a left or a right versus up versus down? We don't know. So what you do is you study the different functions, and you compare it to our what is called the parent function y equals x squared. So let's get a domain here. Domain, as you guys already know, is a set of x values. So let's take a domain from negative 3 to 3, and let's substitute it in here. Remember, all you have to do is just square it. X squared means what number squared, right? So we're going to take y equals x squared. We're going to substitute values from negative 3 to positive 3, which is called the domain. Sorry about that interruption there. We're going to take negative 3 and we're going to square it. Okay, now negative 3 squared is negative 3 times negative 3, which is positive 9. Whatever you square is always positive, you guys know. All right, negative 2, what is that squared? Well, negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4. Negative 1 squared, negative 1 times negative 1 is positive 1. 0, 0 squared is 0, of course. 1. Y equals 1 squared, that's 1. 2 squared is 4. 3 squared, well, that's 9. These are called the parent function values. And after a while, you are going to commit these to memory. You're going to memorize these. Okay, how do you do that? Well, you plot them all, okay? You plot them all, and then you do this a lot. Okay, so the first point is left 3, up 9. So we're gonna plot these. Left 3, here's negative 3, so left 3 up 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. Okay, negative 2 comma 4 is left 2 up 4. Left 1 up 1 is negative 1, 1, it's left 1 up 1. Then we have the origin at 0, 0. And then right 1 up 1. Ooh, there's some symmetry going on here. I could see that negative 1, 1 and 1, 1 are symmetrical about the y-axis here. 2 comma 4, right 2 up 4. See, these two have some symmetry. These two have some symmetry. These two have some symmetry. So symmetry is used all the time with parabolas here. Okay, I'm talking about these two points, and these two points. Okay, they're symmetrical about the y-axis. About the y-axis. Okay, so and then right 3 up 9 right about here. So we're going to draw this parabola, which is called our parent function, y equals x squared. Draw a smooth U-shaped curve, not V. It should be smooth U-shaped, round there. No. Okay, there we go. And they get wider as they get taller, okay? And this is our parent function, y equals x squared. We go right 1, up 1, right 2, up 4, right 3, up 9. Okay? It's symmetrical about the y-axis. Okay, and that y-axis, this is called the axis of symmetry, is x equals 0. The vertex right here is at the origin, 0 comma 0. So we've got some things already known. Again, symmetry means that it is one point is the same distance from another one, but opposite side. Same distance, opposite side. Same distance, opposite side. It's symmetrical. Okay, the left half... Look at this. The left half is symmetrical about the right half. What's the right half? Well, it's this right here. Okay. And so that's an important concept right there, by the way. So we got a vertex 0, 0. We got axis symmetry x equals 0. It's a vertical line, of course. What else? Domain, all reals, as you guys already know. Okay, you can square any, x can be any real number. You can square any real number. Okay. Range, well, let me see. This is a minimum. And the min y value, equals 0. So that means that all these other y values, like 1, 4, and 9, are got to be greater than or equal to it. So y is greater than or equal to 0. Why? Because this is a minimum value, which means this is smallest. All the other y values, like 1, 4, and 9, are obviously bigger or greater than or equal to 0. And that's why we describe the range, which is a set of y values, is that all y values have got to be greater than or equal to 0. Like this one's at 1, and this one's at 4, and this one's at 9, and so on. Okay? Now, these other functions that we're going to graph kind of look like this. They're going to have the same shape, but they're going to be shifted. The question is, how are they shifted? To the left or to the right, up or down? So we're going to compare them to the parent function. So we're going to graph. Let me write this out. We're going to graph this and compare to the parent. All right? And then we're going to figure out what happened. Graph and compare to the parent function, which is y equals x squared right above it. And then when we compare it, we're going to see what happened. What happens when you subtract 2 from x? I don't know. Well, I mean, I do know, but you need to find out. So we find out by doing, right? So let's do that. So here we go. We're going to pick a domain now from, let's say, 0 to... I'm going to start the domain off here at 0, and we're going to go to 0 to 5, okay? So here we go. So 0 minus 2 quantity squared equals negative 2 squared or 4. So your first point is at 0 comma 4. If you want to plot that, let's go for it. It's right here. Now, students always ask me, you know, where do you start the domain? Well, that comes from experience, and I'll talk about that as we develop the ideas. Okay, just go with the flow right now. So when x is 1, what's 1 minus 2 quantity squared? Well, that's negative 1 quantity squared, or 1. So 1 comma 1 is right here. Next one at 2. So 2 minus 2 quantity squared, that's obviously 0. So 2 comma 0 is right here. So we've got some points developing here. And at 3, what's 3 minus 2 squared? Well, it's 1 squared or 1, so 3 comma 1. Oh, it's going back up again. Symmetry, I see symmetry right here. 4, so we have 4 minus 2 quantity squared. 2 squared, which is 4. 4 comma 4, right 4, up 4. See, I see that U-shaped graph coming up, which is called parabola. It's parabolic, okay? So let's graph this curve. Okay, remember, it's smooth U-shaped curve. It's round at the bottom, and then it gets wider as it gets taller. Okay, now I can see already that it's symmetrical about this line. Now the vertex is at 2 comma 0, and the x-coordinate's 2, and this equation of the axis symmetry is x equals 2 because it goes through 2. All right, so I know the axis symmetry, x equals 2. I know the vertex is 2 comma 0. These two values right here, the x-coordinate and this value here, are always the same. The axis symmetry always runs through the vertex. Always runs through the vertex. Okay, remember that. But how is it compared to the parent function above? So let's take a look at it. Okay, so notice, if you were with me in person, we could take a piece of trace paper here. We can trace the parent, okay, and then overlap it with this one. So they would have the same shape. Okay, it'd have the same shape. However, it's been shifted to the right. The vertex went from 0, 0 to 2, 0, went 2 units right. So this has the same shape, but it's been shifted 2 units right. It has the same domain, so let's fill this out. And it's got the domain as a set of all reals, no problem there. Same range, y greater than or equal to 0, because that's a minimum. So it's still going to be y greater than or equal to 0. Different vertex. Now, the vertex has been shifted 2 units right, so let's write that down. The vertex, okay, here's my conclusion here. Vertex has been shifted 2 units right, 2 units to the right, okay? Sometimes there's right shifts, and sometimes there are left shifts. Sometimes there's up shifts and then down shifts. We just learned something right there. If you subtract something from x here, in this case we're subtracting 2, it's a right shift 2 units, okay? That's your h value, by the way. Up here in the general form, it's x minus h, h is 2. So let me write that above it. Y equals quantity of x minus h, quantity squared. In this case, h is 2. So 2 units right. Okay, we learned something there. So what happens when you add 3 instead of subtracting something from x? What happens when you add something to x? What happens there? I don't know. Well, I do know. However, you have to find that out. So we find out by doing. So here we go. We're going to start off the domain at negative 3 again. So here we go. So negative 3 plus 3, quantity squared is 0 squared or 0. I'm going to substitute in right there in for x. So negative 3 comma 0. Actually, I don't want to start off the domain at negative 3. I need to start off to the left. So let me redo that. Okay, so negative 5. We need that. I'm going to start at negative 5. So negative 5 plus 3 quantity squared is negative 2 squared or 4. So left 5 up 4. So left 5, there's 5 right here, up 4. There's the first point. Second point, negative 4. So negative 4 plus 3 quantity squared is negative 1 quantity squared or 1. So left 4 up 1. Next point, negative 3. Negative 3 plus 3 squared is 0 squared or 0. So we're going to have negative 3 comma 0. At negative 2. So negative 2 plus 3 squared is 1 squared or 1. So left 2 up 1. Oh, it's going back up again. So you see that curve happening again? At negative 1, what's negative 1 plus 3 squared is 2 squared or 4. So the last point, negative 1 comma 4, is right here. So we have another parabola again. So if you were with me, we'd have trace paper and we'd trace this thing here. So we'd see that it has the same shape. Excuse me. The same shape. It's symmetrical about this line right here. This is the axis symmetry right here. This is at negative 3 comma 0. There's your vertex, negative 3 comma 0. It's a minimum. Like this was a minimum too. So it's a minimum here. Axis symmetry goes through negative 3, so x equals negative 3 here. And if you compare, and let's compare. Okay, look at that. Same shape. You could take trace paper, overlap, and trace the parent function, it will overlap the second graph here, and it will overlap the third graph. So it's the same shape. I didn't write that down, so let's write it down. It's the same shape as the parent. As the parent, which is, you know, y equals x squared, okay? Same shape. This one has the same shape too, but it's been shifted. How so, though? Okay, how so? Well, let me see. The vertex of the parent is at 0, 0. If you subtract 2, it moves 2 units right. If you add 3 to it, it moves 3 units left. So it's been shifted 3 units left. And I'll talk about why here in a minute. So this one's been shifted. All right, 3 units left. Now, let's talk about that a little bit more. Let me get into that. I'm going to rewrite the function down here. Y equals quantity of x plus 3 quantity squared. I can rewrite that the following way. I can write it as x minus a negative 3 quantity squared. When you subtract a negative, you get a positive, as you guys already know. And notice right here, this value is negative. If you compare that, this is in the form here, x minus h quantity squared, you'll see that h is negative 3. So h equals negative 3, and that's a shift, that's a makes it a left shift, or a shift 3 units left. That's what makes it shift 3 units to the left instead of to the right. Okay, that's what happens here. The domain is still the set of reals for that. The range, is, we have a minimum here, so all the y values are greater than or equal to 0. That hasn't changed. Vertex changed. It moved 3 units left. And axis of symmetry changed. Okay, so if let's review now. Let's go back. If you subtract something from x, the h value is positive 2 here, so it's a 2-unit right shift. If you add something, the h value becomes negative. Again, this is x minus a negative 3 quantity squared. So you can see right here, h is negative. That's why there's a left shift 3 units. It's almost counterintuitive because people see the plus sign, they think right, okay, but it's actually to the left. Okay, so if we know that in advance, then we could graph the other ones fairly easily without a table of values. If you understand the parent function values, because these have the same shape, they follow the same parental function values. Right 1, up 1, right 2, up 4, right 3, up 9. So really all you have to do is plot the vertex and then use these parent values, right 1, up 1, right 2, up 4, right 3, up 9, and then plot and reflect. So let me tell you what I'm talking about here. Let's go on. Let's see here. Describe the change. Let's go on the back side here. And describe, let's first write down what we described, okay, what we found out. So if h is positive, it's a shift right, and if h is negative, it's a shift left, okay? So when we take a look at this, y is equal to the quantity of x minus h squared. If h is positive, okay, look, check this out. If we got two things. If h is positive, shift right. If h is negative, okay, we shift left. Okay, that's all there is to it. So we can use the parental function value. So let me show you how to do it without even doing using a table here. Okay. I'm not going to use it. So what I'm going to first do is understand that this function here can be rewritten as y is equal to x minus a negative 4. Okay? When you have this, when you see a double negative like this, you're actually changing it to addition. So x plus 4 can be rewritten as x minus a negative 4 squared. So if I write down the general form, which is x minus h quantity squared, I can see that h has to be negative 4. So already I know that h is negative 4, and that tells me that it's shift left 4 units. So shift left, not right. Just because there's a plus sign doesn't mean you go to the right. It's actually counterintuitive. It's actually shift left 4 units. And that's where the vertex is. Now let's go up to the parental values, okay? The parent function is a vertex at the origin, 0, 0. And then what you do is you go right 1, up 1, right 1, up 1. At point A, and then right 2 up 4, right 2 up 4 at point B, and then right 3 up 9 at point C. You got to go right 3 up 9. Let's use those values. This right here has the same shape as the parent. So if I remember my parent values, y equals x squared, right 1 up 1, right 2 up 4, right 3 up 9, then this is what I do. I shift the vertex first. So instead of being at the origin, it's 4 units left. So I go 1, 2, 3, 4. I plot a point. There's my vertex. And then I use my parental values. Okay? Well, I start off with a line of symmetry too. And I use my parental values. I go right 1, up 1, from the vertex, right to a 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then reflect. I forgot to reflect this one. Right one, up one, reflect. 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 And then right 3, up 9. 1, 2, 3 to the right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Right here, it's 3 units away from the line of symmetry. So I go 3 units on the other side. 1, 2, 3. Reflect. Okay, and then you draw the curve. There you go. Now you have a minimum here at negative 4, 0. The axis symmetry is x equals negative 4. The domain, all these functions, set of reals, and the range, well, it's greater, this is a minimum, so y greater than or equal to 0. Okay, notice that I did that without the table. And that's what's nice about these things, guys. If you just know where the vertex is and you know that it has the same shape as your parent, again, this is your parent now, then you use your parent values to determine the other values, okay, or the other points. And then, of course, you reflect a little bit to get more points. All right, let me pause. Let me show you something here. I want to show you this program here. So let's put in our function right here. In this right here, this is 4. Let me just double check that. Y equals, it's x plus 4, so I got to change that. So let me change this to plus. There we go. And let's graph. So notice what we have here. Okay, so right here, there we go. We've got the vertex right here. Come on, baby. I thought I'd be able to write on this thing. Okay, well, here's the vertex at negative 4, 0. Right here. Oh, I know what I can do. So you can trace along this function. There's your vertex at negative 4, 0. You go right one, up one, right there. There's your next point. Right one, up one. At negative 3, 1. So left 3, up 1, that's this point right here. Okay, left 3, up 1 is right there. And then you go, and so on. So this graph right here is the same thing as what I did by hand without using a table. I use the parent function values because I know it has the same shape as a parent. In fact, let me write that down again since this is the first time you've seen this. Okay, this has the same shape, okay, as the parent, which we call y equals x squared. So y equals x squared. That's a key concept right here. And because of that, I use the parent function values. Right 1, up 1. Right 2, up 4. Right 3, up 9. Okay, right and up, right and up. And that's how I'm going to graph the next one too. I determine the shift first, and then I graph. So I look here and I compare y equals x minus h quantity squared, and I notice that h is 1. All right, if I put a 1 in there, I get x minus 1 squared. So I notice that h is 1 is positive, so that's a shift right 1 unit. Shift right 1 unit. So the vertex was originally at the origin, but now I just shifted to the right, 1 unit. So now you're here, and that's the vertex. And then you use the parent values. I'll write them down again so you can see them on the screen. So 1, 2, and 3. 1 squared is 1, 2 squared is 4, 3 squared is 9. So I go right 1, up 1 from the vertex. So here we go, right 1, up 1. And as I do that, I reflect it at the same time, so I get 2 points for 1. So I go right 1, up 1, and then I reflect it. And then right 2, up 4, right 2, up 4, and then I reflect. And then I go right 3, up 9, 1, 2, 3 from the vertex, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then I reflect. It's 3 units away, so I go 3 units on the other side. Reflect. 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 Okay? You reflect. You plot and reflect each time, like I've been trying to get you guys to do, and then you draw a smooth U-shaped curve. There we go. And remember, parabolas always get wider as they get taller. Okay, they never curve back inward. So the domain, set of all reals, range, this is a minimum, so it's y greater than or equal to 0. Vertex is not at the origin, it's at 1, 0. All right, axis symmetry goes through 1, so it's x equals 1. Okay, and notice that I did not use the table values. So let me plot this one and prove it to you that what I did was right. So let's change this value to x minus 1, regraph, and you'll see, look right here now, that now the vertex is at 1, 0, just like this graph here. So we'll get some experience and just determine the values of h and k and determine whether it's a left shift, right shift, and you'll practice with me in class a lot. It's going to be fun. And you're going to be able to graph parabolas without the table by going back and using what are called the parent values. These are called the parent values. Okay, and that's really important. You're going to have to memorize these. And they're going to be easy to memorize because when you just square 1, you get 1. When you square 2, you get 4. When you square 3, you get 9. The parent values are easy to memorize. The question is, what happens when you add something to the x squared on outside the quantity here? And so we call that k. So what we're going to do is we're going to base everything upon the parent. So let's go for it again. So let's write down the parent values again, which hopefully you know you've seen it already 3 times. So let's go quicker now. So all you have to do is just square them, right? So negative 3 squared is 9. Negative 2 squared is 4. Negative 1 squared, notice the use of parentheses, is 1. 0 squared is 0. 1. 1 squared is 1. 2 squared is 4. And 3 squared is 9. So these are your parent values. Parent values. You got to memorize these. So once again, you're going to be going, you know, right 1, up 1, right 2, up 4, right 3, up 9. You got to memorize these. These are the parent values, and these are the ones we use. Okay, so let's plot. Okay, my vertex is right here. My vertex, 0, 0. So then I go right 1, up 1, right 2, up 4, right 3, up 9. And then I reflect. Reflect, reflect, reflect. Okay? So there's your parent function again, just so you can have it in your sights. The reason why we do that first is to get good at it, number one, and also to memorize the values. And I'm talking about these values right here. So memorize those. How does the parabola change when you add 2 to the x squared term? What happens? Is it a right shift, left shift, up shift, down shift, side shift? You know, what is it? So let's figure it out, okay? So you figure it out by doing. So let's figure this out. So negative 3, y equals x squared plus 2 now. So what is negative 3 squared plus 2? Well, that's 9 plus 2, or 11. Let's plot as we go. So left 3 up 11. So left 3 up 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11. There's your first point. Negative 2 squared plus 2. That's 4 plus 2, or 6. I'll just bust them out. Negative 1. So what's negative 1 squared plus 2? Well, that's 1 plus 2, or 3. 0 squared plus 2 is 2. 1 squared plus 2, that's 1 plus 2, or 3. 2 squared plus 2, that's 4 plus 2, or 7. Excuse me, 6. Sorry. See symmetry going on, don't you? I sure hope so. Symmetry there, and I should expect 11 here. So 3 squared is 9, plus 2 is 11. So again, look at that. Symmetry. Symmetry, guys. Okay, so let's plot. So left two up six. Left one up three. Up two. There's your vertex right here. That's your vertex. And then left one up, or right one up three, because you're going back up again. Right two up six. And then right three up 11. So let's sketch. Now, if you were in class with me, we'd take out the trace paper and check the shape. If you're at home, you could do that too if you got some. All right. And if you take a look at it, these have the same shape. These two graphs have the same shape. So it's the same shape as the parent, which is called y equals x squared, right? Same shape, but it's been shifted. But it's been shifted. The vertex being, instead of being at 0, 0, the vertex went from here up 2 units. This is an up 2. So this k value right here, that's called k in general, okay? But it's been shifted up 2 units. So if it's positive 2 being added, you're going to expect it to go up 2, okay? But it is shifted, okay, up 2 units. Because that's a positive 2 as opposed to a negative 2. Okay, so when k is positive, it's an upshift. K positive, it's an upshift. That's what you should be learning through this, okay? I know that all the time, so it's easy for me to graph. So notice something here. From the vertex, it's right one up one, right two up four, right two up four. Look at these are the parental values. And then right three up nine. Right three up nine. Those are the parental values. So if I know where the vertex is, I just use the parent values to graph and I can avoid all this arithmetic here. I don't even need it, which is kind of nice. What happens when k is negative? What happens when you subtract 3 from x squared? Well, let's figure that out too. So let's go for it here. So let's take negative 3 squared, subtract 3. That's 9 minus 3 or 6. Negative 2. Negative 2 squared minus 3. It's 4 minus 3 or 1. Negative 1 comma negative 1 squared minus 3. That's 1 minus 3 or negative 2. And negative 2. Negative 2 squared is 4 minus 3. That's 1. And excuse me, what am I doing? Should be going way too fast here. I should go to 0. 0. 0 squared minus 3, that's negative 3. 1 squared minus 3, that's negative 2. 2. 2 squared minus 3, that's 4 minus 3 or 1. And 3 squared minus 3, that's 9 minus 3 or 6. Once again, look at the symmetry here. Symmetry. Okay, so let's plot. Negative 3, 6. So negative 3, comma 6, 2, 4, 6. Left 2 up 1 right here. 0, comma negative 3 is here. Oh, I missed one. Negative 1, comma negative 2 is here. 1, comma negative 2 is here. 2 comma 1 right here, 3 comma 6 right up here. So after you plot your points, I see a curve. I see a parabolic curve. It's called a parabola. Okay. So get your trace paper out and compare it. And when you compare it, you'll see that all three of these graphs have the same shape, but they've been shifted. The parent up top has been shifted down 3 units in this case. It went from right here, it went down 3 units. That's a minus 3. So it's a downshift. So when k is negative, let's write this down. So, first of all, let me write down same shape. That's first thing. Second thing, it's been shifted down. So shifted down 3 units because k is negative. Okay, down. So if I see something being subtracted from the x squared term, the parent, then I know it's a downshift. The vertex is at 0, comma, negative 3. There's your minimum value right there. The axis symmetry is right here is x equals 0. And so on, domain set of reals, y, the range, y is greater than or equal to negative 3 here. But basically what happens is this, if you have y equals x squared plus k, there's two things happening here, okay? If k is positive, all right, it's a shift up. If k is negative, like in this case is negative 3, all right, it's a downshift. Okay, and that's all there is to it. All you need is to get experience, and so you're going to get experience with me. All right? Okay. The only thing we got to do is practice. So I'll see you in class, and you guys will get a whole lot of practice with me up there on the smart board, and we'll shift these parabolas around and learn how to use what are called the parent values, so that we can avoid this table right here and we can go right to the graph. All right. This is Mr. Ainsworth. I'll see you in my next lesson. Bye-bye.